this lecture we will discuss your routing and routing protocol, explain the significance of static routing, configure static and default route, verify and troubleshoot static and default route, identify the classes of routing protocol, identify distance vector routing protocol, identify link state routing protocol, describe the basic characteristic of common routing protocol, identify interior gateway protocol, identify exterior gateway protocol, enable routing information protocol RIP on a router table. Before we begin, let's discuss the routing table and directly connected route. This information, which is not in the curriculum, but will give you a better understanding of what is taking place. Directly connected network and the IP routing table. Show IP route. You can see all the detail. Gateway of last resort is not set. The routing table prior to any interface configuration. The command to view the IP routing table is privilege or user mode. Show IP route. Currently no route in the routing table. Directly connected network and the IP routing table. Interface is 0. IP address 192.168.2.1 subnet mask. No shutdown command are used to open the port. Again, show IP route command are used. Other port gateway information omitted. IP/24 is directly connected Ethernet 0. Adding an IP address mask to an interface tell router that it is a member directly connected to that network. Just like when a host computer is configured with an IP address mask, notice the route is shown with the subnet mask and the exit interface. Do not forget the no shutdown. Do not forget the interface must be in up and off. Directly connected network and the IP routing table. Debug IP routing. Interface is 0. IP address 192.168.2.1 and subnet mask. No shutdown. Show IP route. Again, /24 is directly connected. Undebug all. Viewing the routing table process, use the debug IP routing command to view the Cisco IOS routing table process of adding a directly connected network to the routing table. When finish, be sure to use undebug all. Debug command are used to view detailed information about Cisco IOS processes. More later. Directly connected network and the IP routing table. Debug IP routing. Instruction is 0. Shutdown. Interface Ethernet 0. Remove from routing table. 192.168.2.0 through 0.0.0.0. Interconnected matrix 0/0. Delete network route to 192.168.2.0. Show IP route. Undebug all. Viewing the routing table process, directly connected route will also be removed if the link goes down. Directly connected route will only be in the routing table if it is not administratively down. The line is up and protocol is up. For serial interfaces, do not forget the clock rate command on the router with the DCE cable. Neither interface will be up and up until both end are configured correctly. Directly connected network and the IP routing table. Show IP route. Show IP route. Again, show IP route. The routing table, you can see the three routing show IP route command and their detail. The routing table, notice that the routers only know about their own directly connected network. They are not sharing routing information because we have not configured any static route or dynamic routing protocol. Directly connected network and the IP routing table. Instruction is 0. IP address 10.1.0.0. Show IP route. Configuring interface which has a subnet mask greater than the classful mask. We will discuss this in much more detail later using the presentation. The routing table. far now notice that when the subnet mask is not a class full mask but a subnetted /16 mask, the routing table information shows the route to the subnetted network. The mask is shown in the above parent class full network connected network, and the IP routing table show IP route ping 172.16.0.2, ping 192.168.1.1, 192.168.1.2, 10.1.0.1. Routing only directly connected host routers. Router can only reach network known about in its own routing table. Directly connected network and the IP routing table show IP route is directly connected serial 0, dash is directly connected Ethernet 0, sending 500 byte ICMP equal to 172.16.0.1, timeout is 2 seconds, success rate is 100% 5x5 round trip, minimum average maximum 56x57 60 microsecond, ping 172.16.0.2. Routing table must have the necessary network routes. Question: if RTA can ping RTB 172.16.0.2 interface, why cannot it ping RTB 192.168.1.1 interface? RTA does not have a route to it in the routing table. Question: would an extended ping from RTA using the route source IP address of 192.168.2.1 be able to ping 172.16.0.1 on RTB? Why or why not? Where does the echo request or echo reply fail? Directly connected network in the IP route routing tables show IP route, show IP route ping target IP address extended commands source address or interface 192.168.2.1 sending 500 byte ICMP equal to 16.0.2, timeout is 2 seconds. Routing table must have the necessary network route. Question: would an extended ping from RTA using the source IP address of 192.168.2.1 be able to ping 2.16.0.1 on RTB? Why or why not? The echo request from RTA reaches RTB because RTA has a route to 192.16.0.0/16 in its routing table. However, the echo reply from RTB back to RTA failed because RTB does not have a route for 2.168.2.0/24 in its routing table. IP routing network in the IP routing table show IP route, show IP route, show IP route. Routing table principle revisited. Zen Cisco IP routing. Every router make its decision alone based on the information it has in its own routing table. The fact that one router has certain information in its routing table does not mean that other router have the same information. Routing information about a path from one network to another does not provide routing information about the reverse or return path. Static router operation show IP route. IP route command, IP route prefix mask address interface distance take command prefix IP route prefix for the destination mask prefix mask for the destination address IP address of the next hop that can be used to reach that network interface to use exit interface distance optional and stateful distance take optional take value that can be used as a match value for controlling redistribution through route map. CCNP advanced routing permanent optional specify that the route will not be removed even if the interface shut down. CCNP static route operation if the exit interface gateway is down, the static route will not be put in the router. If the router cannot read the outgoing interface that is being used in the route will not be installed in the routing table. This means if that interface is down, the route will not be placed in the routing. Stateful distance and metric show IP route. Administrator distance routing metric or cost for all static route is 0. The default administrator distance for static route is 1. Administrator distance is the trustworthiness of the routing information, lower the industry rotation, the more trustworthy the information. If the router hear about a route to the same network from more than one source, it will use the administrator distance to decide which route to put in the routing table. From the curriculum, two choices, we will see the differences in a moment. From the curriculum, the network 0.0.0.0 and MA 0.0.0 are known as a default route, can be written 0.0.0.0/0, known as a quad zero route more later. Static routing, some extra information on static routing that is not in the curriculum. Router IP route, destination prefix, mask, address, enterprise, distance, state, tag, permanent. Static routing, configure static route. Router do not need to configure static route for their own directly connected network. We need to configure static route for network. This router need to reach. We will need to configure a static route for the other router as well. As routing information about a path from one network to another does not provide routing information about the reverse or return path convergence. When all the routers in the network AS have accurate and consistent information so that proper routing and packet forwarding can take place, convergence will not happen until all the routes have complete and accurate routing information, meaning we must configure static route on all the router before packet will be correctly delivered. Static routing IP route 192.168.1.0/2.5.2.5.2.5.0/2.1.16.0.2. Network subnet route intermediate address usually next hop. Show IP route code connected static. Is directly connected serial 0. Basic static route example, you should use the proper subnet mask. IP route 192.168.1.0 subnet mask. Show IP route code C connected as static. Basic static route example, continued administrator distance / metric. Administrator distance, this is the trustworthiness of the routing information. The default administrator distance of static route is 1. The administrator distance of a directly connected route is 0. Lower the AD, the more trustworthy. If the router learn about a route to a network from more than one source, it will install the route with the lower administrator distance in the routing table. Static routing IP route 192.168.1.0 subnet mask 172.16.0.2. Show IP route. Basic static route example, continued 1/0 administrator distance / metric. Metric, this is the cost of getting to this route, that is how far away this network is. The lower the cost, the closer the network. Static route always show a cost of 0 even if it was configured with the intermediate address is multiple hop away. Much more later, static routing RTA config IP route, IP address subnet mask. Show IP route recursive lookup. The router know it can get to 192.168.1.0/24 network by forwarding the packet to the router at the IP address of 172.16.0.2. How does the router know how to get to the IP address 2.16.0.2? It does a recursive lookup first by looking up the 192.168.1.0.24 network and finding it need to forward the packet to 172.16.0.2. The router then look up the 172.16.0.0 network and see it can forward it out the interface serial 0. Routing debug IP routing IP routing debugging is on config t enter configuration command 1 per line in with control z. IP route 192.168.1.0/2.5.2.5.2.5.0/172.16.0.2. Static metric IP route 10.1.0.0/2.5.2.5.0/172.16.0.2. RTA config undebug all static route and the routing table process. Notice that the static route is entering into the routing table by the routing table process debug IP routing with a metric of 0. Static routing IP route 182.168.1.0.2.5.2.5.2.5.0.0.16.02 IP route 10.1.0.0.2.5.2.5.0.1 IP route 182.168.2.0.2.5.2.5.0.0.16.0.1 IP route 10.1.0.0 subnet mask 2.5.2.5.0.0.182.168.1.2 IP route 192 subnet mask 2.5 network address 192.168.1.1 IP route 172.16.0.0 subnet mask 2.5.2.5.0.0 192.168.1.1 Configuring all of the static route, notice that the intermediate address is always the next hop IP address. This does not always have to be the case, and we will look at other option in the presentation on static route. Additional information: what idea to do a copy running config startup config. If everything is working right, to verify the route or in there, you can do a router show running config. IP route 192.168.1.0.2.5.2.5.2.5.0 172.16.0.2 IP route 10.1.0.0.2.5.2.5.0.0 172.16.0.2 Show IP route ports connected static ping 10.1.0.0 ping 192.168.1.2 ping 192.168.1.1 static routing recursive lookup RT IP route 192.168.1.0.2.5.2.5.2.5.0.2.16.0.2 show IP route recursive lookup the router no it can get to 192.168.1.0 state 24 network by forwarding the packet to the router at the IP address of 172.16.0.2. How does the router know how to get to the IP address 172.16.0.2? It does a recursive lookup pass by looking up the 192.168.1.0/24 network and finding it need to forward the packet to 172.16.0.2. The router then look up the 172.16.0.0 network and see it can forward it out the interface serial 0. RTA config static routing recursive lookup IP route 10.1.0.0/2.5.2.5.0.0.182.168.1.2 show IP route recursive lookup continue. We can take this even further. One route can be used to resolve the route of another. It does not matter how the route are resolved, whether they are directly connected, static or dynamic. Note an intermediate address cannot be resolved that route and any route it affect are not installed in the routing table. Note regarding recursive route lookup, every route that does not reference an exit interface must finally be resolved through a route with an interface descriptor reference in the corresponding path descriptor or route with an exit interface. Static route cannot be recursively resolved and will not be in the routing table. Consider these three static routes: IP route 10.1.0.0/2.5.2.5.0.0 20.111 IP route 20.1.0.0/2.5.2.5.0.0 30.1.1.1 IP route 30.1.0.0/2.5.2.5.0.0 10.1.1.1 Route 1 is resolved by Route 2, which is resolved by Route 3. None of these routes are finally resolved through a route with an exit interface. This leads to endless recursion. Routing table process will not permit the static route to be entered in the routing table. Note static default route coming soon can never be resolved through another default route.